Hi, I want to talk about battery management systems. It's for example for the 18650 batteries. I bought a bunch of battery holders for this battery and I've soldered a battery management system on this. So I don't want to explain how to connect the battery management system to the batteries. It's there are a lot of YouTubers that that are telling them you put them in series like this, four, and you just connect them to the battery management system. And that's what I wanted to talk about, because I thought the battery management system will balance the batteries out. So you have four batteries and the battery management system wants to balance the batteries. But that's not true. The balancing board of the battery management system is not balancing the batteries out. So what do they do? Well, I have an example here. There is a BMS board at the back of this battery pack. I took one battery out and I've connected a little power supply instead of the battery. So the power supply is acting like if it's a battery. So now I can change the voltage of one of the batteries. So I can act like one of the batteries is running out. So what you see here is an ammeter. It's measuring 11 milliamps because there I have a voltage meter connected on it. And this is the voltage meter is drawing 11 milliamps. You can see all the batteries are 3.8 volts. The cells that are inside, they won't change. Don't worry about that. They keep 3.8 volts. So now to see what exactly happens, I will disconnect the voltage meter. So now the ammeter is measuring no current, but there is still 3.5 volts here. Now 3.6, 3.8, 3.9, 4 volts. Now the battery is almost full that's supposed to be in here. These batteries are still 3.8, so there is a voltage difference. Why is the balancing board not balancing these batteries out? That's because they are not supposed to do that. The BMS is not designed to balance the batteries out when there's nothing happening. The only thing something is going to happen is when the voltage of the charged battery is too high. Now watch what happens. 4 points. Oh, cool. You see that? Now the voltage is much too high because the maximum voltage of the 18650 batteries is 4.2. Now this is much too high. So there is a current. The battery management system is drawing a current from this battery, and that current is 60 milliamps. Now I lower the voltage. I lower it. Look. Now the current is gone. So that battery is not draining its energy anymore. It stays stable. This is the battery management system. Now I will show the battery management system up very close to my good old microscope. Well, here it is. And yeah, there's a lot to do here. So what is all that? These are MOSFETs. These are resistors. So what's happening here? Well, I have a schematic. Now don't be scared. It's not that complicated. I will show you the schematic from closer. Closer, even closer. Now Let's go up, closer, up. Here are the connections. This is the B plus. This is the B3 connection. This is the P plus connection also. They're together, the B plus and the P plus. The B3 is not connected to some other connection. Now you can see the B plus and the P here. This is the B plus. This is the P plus. Now closer. Look, P plus, B plus are connected together, like the schematic is showing us. The B3 connection is here. You can't read it because there's a wire running over it, but this is the B3 connection. So these two connections are connected to one of the batteries. Now let's go back to the schematic. Closer, higher. This is where we were. So this lead all the way up is all connected to the B plus, and this lead here horizontally is connected to the minus of this battery. So there's a battery between here. Now if we go to the right, then we can see a little schematic, a very simple little schematic here. You see? So this is a here is a battery. This is the plus. This is the minus. Can you see my mouse? And everything that's between those two leads is this schematic. Now we can see two resistors here. Those two resistors are... Oh, sorry. This one. Okay, look. Those are the resistors. Those two are connected to the B plus. You can see that? So those two resistors are acting as a load. So back to the schematic. Oh, sorry about that. I go back. Here, those are the two resistors. They're a load. So this is a MOSFET. This is some kind of IC that will take care of the overvoltage, because when the voltage is higher than 4.2 volts, it will activate the MOSFET. And that MOSFET is connecting those two resistors to the minus of the battery. So that's the overvoltage protection. And that protection is for every battery. This is battery 1. This is the same schematic for battery 2. This is the same schematic for battery 3. And this is the same schematic for battery 4. So this is quite clear. This part of the schematic is for the overvoltage. Now we have this part of the schematic. Look, they're all the same. This part for battery 1, battery 2, battery 3, battery 4. This part is connected to this part of the schematic. Now what is that for kind of part? These are all MOSFETs. These MOSFETs can disconnect these two leads. So the minus of the battery and the minus of the load or the charger, could be both, that minus can be disconnected by the MOSFETs. Now what is running these MOSFETs on and off? Those are all these parts of the schematic. So let's test that out. I've just showed you what the over voltage protection looks like. Look, it's on, now it's off. The over voltage protection is working. But what happens when you have an under voltage? Well, then we need a load. The output switch will do nothing without a load, so we need a load. I just connected an LED. You can see that the output is switched on. Now the voltage of that output is 15.5 volts. That's the total voltage of all the four batteries. So there is a very little load. This LED is only drawing 20 milliamps. Here we are. Okay, that battery has a very low capacity. So it's running out very, very fast. Here we go. Oh dear. My battery is running out. And it's the only one of that four batteries that is so bad. But the output is still on. Now we go to a critical point of the voltage. 2.6, 2.5, 2.4. Oh, okay. So the output is turned off by the MOSFETs now. And if the voltage is coming up again, nothing happens. Oh, the overvoltage still works, but the output is not going on because you have to disconnect the load and then the output will turn itself on. You see? Now it's on again. Let's do that again. The battery is running out. 2.5, 2.4. Oh! The output is off again. So that part of the schematic is functioning great. That left part. I showed you the right part. That's the over voltage protection. Now this is the under voltage protection. So when the voltage is running out, the lead on the left side over here, that leads go down, way down, all the way down to this part of the schematic, and those are the switches, the MOSFETs that will switch the output off. So that's all a battery management system is doing. It's an over voltage protection, but it's also an under voltage protection. It will not balance the batteries out when there is nothing happening. The only point where the batteries are balanced is when the batteries are getting charged all the way up to 4.2 volts, because then the over voltage protection is going to take care of the battery's balancing moment. That's 4.2 volts. When the batteries are getting charged, they are balanced. But if the capacity from the four batteries is not the same, then the output will turn off when the lowest capacity battery is running out. So if these batteries are very good and there is only one bad battery, then the whole package will turn itself off when the lowest battery, the baddest battery, is running out. So if you have a bicycle, an electric bicycle with a battery pack that is bad, you can open it and just find the baddest battery, replace that, and the other batteries may still be very good. I hope you learned something. Until the next time. Bye bye.